Yes, I went to medical school here in Washington, D.C. I moved to New York right after getting out of residency, and I was working in a large hospital in downtown New York. And while I was there, I started to recognize that you can treat one patient at a time, but that really doesn't get you very far. And I wanted to tackle bigger targets. And also, we weren't really doing anything about a heart attack until it came into the emergency room door. And yet the most important things that you can do have to do with all the things that are going to cause that heart attack, and that has to do with what people are eating more than anything else. You know, I can't speak for other physicians, but I have to say I remember very distinctly feeling that if you just see one patient with a heart attack and then another patient with high blood pressure and another patient with diabetes, at some point you got to just back up and say, what is causing all of this? And this is not just a local problem or even a national problem. This is an international problem related to food choices that people are making. The flip side of that is there is a big solution that you can put to work right away in your own life. Up until recently, we didn't really think of nutrition as being a very strong force. You know, you eat a little bit less carbs and nothing much happens, or you count calories for a few weeks and you lose a few pounds and then you gain it all back. And I think people have gotten used to the idea that food doesn't make much difference. And I really think that's because they weren't trying the right food changes. Foods are the cause of diabetes, of heart disease, of many forms of cancer, of hypertension. And if they're the cause, they can also be the solution. That's been a totally new idea for many people, but it's a very powerful one. There are genes for diabetes. There are genes for blood pressure. There are genes for heart disease. But those genes aren't dictators. You know, the genes for blue eyes, those are dictators. They give orders, you're going to have blue eyes. The genes for diabetes are like committees. They make suggestions, and you can argue with them. You can say, I don't think I'm going to have diabetes because I'm going to change my diet and my lifestyle, and I'm going to push those genes away. And you can do that. And that is true for a surprising range of conditions, from diabetes to certain forms of cancer to even Alzheimer's disease, we believe. These are things where we can shift that balance, and we can shift it dramatically. You know, we started out to do a study for diabetes. And our approach is to really bring in the plant-based foods for diabetes, and that's our goal. But in the course of this study, what you discover is here's a woman who says, not only is my diabetes a whole lot better and I've lost a lot of weight, but my arthritis is gone. Why did that happen? Or here's a man who says, my erectile dysfunction went away. Which, by the way, these are sometimes bigger motivators than the diabetes themselves. But what we discover is when you're putting the right fuel in your tank, a lot of things get better.